let's look at success on the pitch, because that's what you want, and I'm guessing you will be wanting to achieve that against Newcastle at the weekend. And it's a team that, you know, this time last year you'd gone to them off the back of a very good win, I think it was against Quins, and you didn't perform as well as you wanted at the time. How important is it that you banish those memories of Kingston Park from the best part of a year ago?
Well, again, I mean, it's just about keeping pressure on being the part of the table we want to be in, and obviously gathering points is all we're concerned about. Yes, we felt we probably let ourselves down a little bit last year, but at the same time, Newcastle performed well. You know, I remember talking in my comments afterwards, I wasn't going to take anything away from Newcastle. I thought they outplayed us on the day and deserved the win. What we have to make sure we do is we put in a performance that merits the win. That's all you can focus on. We've not overly talked too much about it was a game we should have won or anything like that, because, you know, that's very disrespectful to Newcastle. Mm-hmm. What we have to talk about is that we have to put in a performance that merits the win, and that'll gather us points, and that'll keep us where we want to be in the table. But to do that, you have to show respect for the opposition, as you do in every Premiership game. And my big belief is the way you show respect is that you prepare very, very well. You know, there's no bigger respect you show a team than going after them as hard as you can, because that shows, you know, that you generally respect them, and you know you have to play well to beat them. And that's what our talk and our focus has been this week.
Do you draw strength from that European Challenge Cup quarter-final win that you had against them here? I think you put over 40 points on them that day.
Not really. I mean, I'm not a big one for looking back and saying this is the history of the results, or this is what, you know, I'm very much for this week, and this is how we have to play, and this is how we have to perform. To be fair, the players are focused really well on that. We've had some good training days. That the players are looking enthusiastic and sharp, as they should be. You know, they should be enjoy being in this big, you know, it's a fantastic season. We've got a lot of important games week in, week out. There's great opportunities for a large number of the squad, and we feel pretty good about ourselves. We feel we're playing pretty well. So we've had a good training week this week, but the important thing is going to be getting on the plane, getting to Newcastle, and, you know, in a 1 o'clock kickoff, we have to get our timings right, turn up in the right frame of mind, and go from there. You know, all we can really ask the players is to concentrate on their frame of mind, and having a real focus on being a really good Premiership team on the day.
That's all I need. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Rob, this weekend, 100 Premiership League appearances for Matt Jess, one of the longest serving boys. It just shows how far and how well he's come on through the club.
Yeah,
since,
that's right.
Since the days.
And Jesse, I mean, last week, Mooney, I think, and Steno's done, 150 now or something. You know, the guys are knocking them on, and it's fantastic to see. And I think it's a great credit to the players. And I think that's the thing we've got to do first and foremost, is credit these guys for the hard work they've put in. I think we like to think here at the club we give them a great structure to be able to improve and be able to perform and go out and enjoy their rugby. But the truth is, we put a structure in place that says, go on then, if you work very hard, you've got a chance to be successful. And what you'll see is you'll see good characters come through it time and time again. And I think that's what you're seeing with Matt Jess. You know, he's been a fantastic character. He works extremely hard. He's done everything he can do, really, probably to maximise his potential. And he's been a very important member of the playing squad now for a long time. You know, gives it a lot of good characteristics, has a lot of good traits, is a great example. He's one of our players who gets held up as a great example by our academy players, publicly, you know, to other people. And I think that probably says everything. You know, he's consummate professional, but he's also a guy who knows how to be a good member of the squad and drive the qualities we ask for. I'm delighted for him, and, you know, long may it continue. You know, he's going along really well.
And you talk about that core group that came up from the Championship, that experience they have now. This is the sixth season in the Premiership, is really coming to fore now.
Yeah, that's right. And I think it's like anything, isn't it? If these guys stay physically focused and look after themselves, you know, there's no reason why you can't clock up a lot of games. So I think Jesse's a great example of that. And it kind of shows, you know, people start talking about the intensity of the Premiership and how difficult seasons are, and you won't see guys, you know, being at one club and getting 100 caps and this kind of stuff, and you're seeing it over and over. You know, it's happening quite regularly now here at Exeter, you know, and I think I don't think there's a magic formula. It's about the player. The player has to show the qualities that mean the club want to keep picking him, and they also show the qualities that the club want to keep him around, and he's got to show the same qualities that he doesn't want to get bored with working very hard, because that's what it's going to take to rock up in a Premiership team every week. And as I say, you know, Jesse's shown those qualities in spades, and as have a few others. And I think together they've kind of pulled each other along probably at dark times, because there's no doubt in our time in the Championship and in the Premiership there's been some tough weeks. There's been some tough training weeks. There's been some tough reviews. There's been some tough moments. There's been some heartbreakers, you know, but these guys are very resilient, and, you know, they come through it together.
And you talked as well that last week in the aftermath that you've got to build off last week's performance. No point going to Newcastle and letting that standard slip again. You set a real benchmark last week.
Yeah, I've no doubt. You know, you look at our last two performances, and you could say, well, Exeter are going to have a decent Premiership season. I think that would be an easy summation to make. But I think we've got to battle that with everything we can, because you don't want to just have an okay Premiership season. You know, as good as that is, you know, having an okay Premiership season is still pretty good because there's some quality sides in there. But you've got to fight that. You've got to fight to, if you put in a good performance, you've got to fight to put in a better one the week after. And that's the thing we've got to use to excite us and challenge us. You know, I want the team to be excited about playing better this week than they did last week. And I think that's what will make us have a good season. It'll just be us not resting on our laurels. It'll be us showing a little bit more consistency game by game across the Premiership than we showed last year. You know, we've talked about it in plenty. We know what we've got to do. Knowing it and kind of producing it on the pitch is the battle, isn't it? And that's going to take a group of highly motivated, well-focused men who want to achieve something. But I get the feeling they do. You know, walking around the change room, I think they feel happy with each other. I think they feel... they've got a good combination of characters in there, and I think, you know, things are just getting a little bit better day by day.